With 8 adorable children, a loving husband, and a stable job, one woman from Burundi, Africa could say that she was living the life she had always dreamed of. Though she had experienced a lot of problems and troubles in the past, those days were gone. Noela left Burundi after her first husband died, and flew all the way to Australia to a new home and a new life. Her future seemed bright. She planned to spend the rest of her days with her new husband, enjoying Australia's beautiful landscape as her kids grow up. Gone are the days where she needed to scour and beg for food. Her husband was a good provider and her children were all loving and supportive. However, when she returned to her native country for a very important reason, she had no idea that everything in her life was about to change. In 2004, Noela Rukundo left her native home in Burundi to search for a brighter future in Australia. Her first husband had died and left her with 5 children. With big dreams for her kids, the widow mustered all of her courage and decided to try her luck in a foreign land. It seemed that Noela made the right choice. Soon enough, she found a new job and a nice place to stay with the help of a resettlement agency. The Australians were friendly, and she was offered all the help she could get, and thankfully her kids didn't have trouble adjusting to their new home. Noela was very thankful for the blessings in her life, and would soon meet someone who would make her very happy. Or so she thought. Keep reading to find out who this mysterious person was. Still depending on the social worker who helped her and her family to build a new life in Australia, Noela often visited the agency. It was there where she met Balanga Kalala, a refugee from Congo. Since Kalala already knew how to speak English, he was often asked by the social worker to translate for Noela. At that time, she only knew Swahili. During those encounters, the two fell in love. Noela was a widow with 5 kids and Kalala was newly single. She soon learned that he fled to Australia after a rebel army attacked and ransacked their small village in Congo. In that unfortunate incident, his wife and young son were killed. With no reason left to stay, he decided to start a new life in a foreign land as well. Up next, Noela's future starts to take a new, unexpected route. Noela had no plans of getting married again. She wanted to dedicate her life to raising her children. However, when she met Kalala, everything changed. He was sweet and caring, and he always made her laugh. Moreover, he completely accepted her situation. In a short period of time, Noela fell head over heels for Kalala. Needless to say, the two decided to live together. They moved into the Melbourne suburb of Kings Park. Kalala treated her children as his own. In the years that followed, she bore him 3 more children. However, she soon began to discover her second husband's personality, and it truly terrified her. Noela had no complaints about her husband when it came to providing for their family. Since he came as a refugee to Australia in 2004, he worked hard and found steady employment soon enough. He worked in a seafood processing factory first before finding a better job as a forklift operator in a warehouse. However, while living together under one roof, Noela, a violent side of her husband was revealed. When he was tired, he would often shout and get mad at small things. There were times when he would physically hurt her. But after the rage, he would come to her like a tame sheep and would beg for forgiveness. As a wife and a mother, she would often disregard the incident and instead, learn to accept the situation. Keep reading to find out why Noela would forever regret letting those incidents slide. Back in Burundi, Noela was raised by her stepmother. Although she was thousands of miles away from home, she made it to a point to send her regards to her relatives in Africa. Thanks to technology, she was always updated on what was happening back there. However, one day, the news that arrived from home was not good. Her stepmother had sadly succumbed to her sickness and passed away. Of course, she needed to go home to Burundi to pay her respects. Unfortunately, her husband couldn't accompany her due to work responsibilities. But unbeknownst to her, something would happen that would completely rock Noela's world. From Melbourne, Australia, Noela traveled 7,500 miles to reach Burundi. She needed to get some things done and, of course, to attend the funeral. It would be the last time she would see the amazing woman who raised her. Her husband, Kalala, kept on checking on her through phone calls. Since her home in Burundi was small, Noela decided to check in a hotel Bujumbura. She was feeling stressed, sad, and exhausted and missed her husband and children as well. After the funeral service, she went back to her hotel room to get some rest. Just in time, her phone rang. Up next, the call that would set an evil plan in motion. The call was from her husband. She answered it right away and instantly detected the sound of concern in Kalala's voice. She was feeling so lonely, and his call was one of the things she needed to calm her anxieties. According to her husband, he was trying to get a hold of her the whole day. He asked how she was doing, and she replied she was going to go to bed to get some rest from the hard day she had. Instead of saying goodnight, Kalala advised her to get some fresh air outside. Noela was used to obeying her husband, so she decided to follow his suggestion. She had no idea that it was the beginning of something she never thought could happen to her. The sudden turn of unfortunate events. Noela was only a few steps out of the hotel compound when she noticed a man approaching her. With little time to react, her heart dropped as she realized that a gun was pointed to her. The stranger told her something that kept her from screaming. He threatened, "Don't scream. If you start screaming, I will shoot you. They're going to catch me, but you? You will already be dead." Although she felt that her heart was about to beat out of her chest from fear, she decided that it would be wiser to do as she's been told. Keep reading to discover the horror Noela endured. The assaulter motioned Noela towards a car parked on the side of the road. There were three guys waiting for her. One was the driver and the other two were holding guns. Trying to appear as calm as she could be, she was forced to sit between two men. Before the car drove off, she was blindfolded. According to her speculation, they drove for 40 minutes. No one was speaking while they were in the car. When the car finally stopped, she was shoved outside and was pushed inside an empty building. Noela was then tied to a chair. As she sat in the chair, she thought back on her life and wondered how she could have ended up there. What did they want from her? Click next to find out. Still holding her tongue, Noela heard one of the kidnappers make a call to alert their boss. Then they turned to her and asked her some disturbing questions. The questions were direct, like, "What did you do to this man? Why has this man asked us to kill you?" For Noela, nothing made sense. She only answered, "Which man?" She couldn't remember anyone whom she had trouble with. As far as she knows, she didn't have any problem with anybody. However, when the man answered her question, it felt like he dropped a bomb. Keep reading to find out who wanted Noela dead. The kidnapper's answer was firm. He said, "Your husband." Time stopped for Noela. There had to be some sort of mistake. Kalala would never do that. She even accused them of lying. And then she was slapped. The leader of the group told her how stupid she was. To further prove his point, he called the man who had paid them to kill her. Noela's mind was spinning. The only thing that kept her from completely losing it was for her to pretend she was in some sort of nightmare. This couldn't really be happening. But it was, and when they called the man who hired them to kill her, reality started to creep up on her. The worst thing she had ever heard in her entire life. When the call was connected, the leader of the kidnappers triumphantly announced that they had Noela, and she was being held captive. The phone was put on a loudspeaker so that she could hear the man on the other line. Then, the truth stabbed her like a knife. "Kill her." The same voice that consoled her an hour earlier sounded like a monster to her ears now. The man whom she'd given 11 years of her life, the man who was the father of her children, had ordered these men to murder her. When the kidnappers discussed how they would kill her and dispose of her body, the true horror set in. It was then that she passed out. Would Noela get out alive? Keep reading to find out what happened next. More revelations. As the leader of the kidnappers ended the call, Noela was regaining consciousness. She felt like her situation was hopeless and nothing could save her anymore. As she was preparing her mind to accept her unfortunate fate, she noticed the kidnappers looking at her intently. "We're not going to kill you. We don't kill women and children. Upon hearing this, a little surge of hope rose. She didn't even know how to react. Then, the leader asked her why she hadn't noticed in the past that something was wrong. It was January and the order to kill her was planned in November of last year. Noela tried to remember what she had done to her loving husband. Try as she might, she couldn't remember anything, nor did she sense this could ever happen to her. But if her husband was intent on having her killed, who was to say he wouldn't try again? Click next to discover what Noela does next. Noela's life was in danger. However, when the kidnappers decided to spare her life, she knew she couldn't give up now. The paid assassins didn't believe in killing women and children. At that moment, an overwhelming sense of gratefulness washed over her. She thanked God for sparing her. Noela spent the next 2 days in the abandoned building they had brought her to. During this time, the kidnappers told her husband that she was already dead. They also took the opportunity to extort more money from Kalala. Her husband willingly shipped the money. Up next, Kalala makes a show of his grief as Noela plots her next moves. Back in the hotel where she was staying, Noela's brother was looking for her everywhere after her disappearance. She had never told him when she would fly back home to Melbourne. And moreover, her things were still in the room. Suspecting that something bad had happened to her, her brother reached out to Kalala. According to her brother, he asked Kalala for $545 to pay the police to open an investigation. The husband instantly wired the money and even expressed how worried he was. However, his fake worries were not close to being over. Released from captivity. After 2 days of being held captive, the assassins finally told her what she was dying to hear. The gang leader, however, had a piece of advice and a warning for her. He said that she was extremely lucky they were murderers with principles, and she needs to remember that not everyone is the same. According to him, Kalala was very serious. He wanted her dead. Noela was given 80 hours to leave the country. Before leaving her on the side of the road, the leader handed her a memory card. It was a piece of evidence that contained all the recorded phone calls. They even provided the receipts for the Western Union money transfer. Noela would never forget the last words she heard from the kidnappers. They told her, "We just want you to go back, to tell other stupid women like you what happened. You must learn something. You people get a chance to go overseas for a better life. But the money you are earning, the money the government gives to you, you use it for killing each other." In the middle of the night and on the side of the road, Noela realized she had very little time to lose. Right away, she called the pastor of her church, Desano Hirono Nantagma, back in Melbourne. The pastor was shocked to hear her voice, due to Kalala having told the town that his wife had gone missing. When Noela told the pastor about her husband's evil plan, he almost didn't believe her. In the end, however, the pastor was convinced to help her. Noela begged him not to tell anyone that she was still alive. For her, she was given a new life to straighten things out. She needed revenge, and to get her kids away from that evil man. Back in their family home in Melbourne, Australia, Kalala appeared like a grieving widower. Days ago, when he received the assassins' call that they have already killed Noela, he had informed the community that she died in a tragic accident in Burundi. Kalala spent the day mourning with well-wishers. Many of those who came to offer their support and compassion donated money. He looked like a devastated husband who had lost someone so dear to him. However, Noela wasn't going to let him get away with this. He had no idea she was still alive, and she was ready to serve up some revenge. On February 22, 2015, Noela had returned safely to Melbourne. More careful and vigilant than ever, she got news of the fake funeral her husband had cunningly organized. Of course, it's an honor to be able to attend your own funeral alive, and Noela couldn't pass up the chance. It was around 7:30 p.m. when Noela, sitting on a parked car just in front of their home, noticed that her husband was escorting the last group of well-wishers into their cars. As they drove away, she decided that it was the perfect time to present her surprise. When Kalala was left alone on the porch, Noela slowly made her entrance. Even in the dark, she saw her husband's reaction upon seeing her. His mouth was open wide, and a look of fear was beginning to show. She walked closer, not speaking any words. Her husband began muttering to himself. It was as if he was seeing a ghost. When they were inches apart, Kalala touched her shoulders. Then he jumped. When he reached out to touch her again, it was then that he realized she was not just an apparition. Kalala then started to scream, asking for forgiveness. In the past, Noela had always forgiven Kalala for hurting her physically. She even believed him when she said that his violence was just a result of the trauma he got from his native land. She loved him dearly, and she was always willing to accept him. But this was completely beyond the scope of forgiveness. Noela called the police she had contacted beforehand. They ordered Kalala off the premises. A few days later, she obtained a court order against him. To make her case against him stronger, she followed the policeman's order to call her husband. It was then that he made a full confession. Without his knowledge, the murder confession was being recorded on tape. Rejecting the accusations. According to Kalala, he loved her so much and suspected that she would later leave him for another man. He said that the evil deed was planned out of jealousy. But no matter how much he tried, Noela's heart and mind were already made up. She had learned her lesson, the hard way, and would never take him back. Noela pursued a criminal case against him. With all the pieces of evidence she had, she knew that she would get the justice she deserved. When Kalala was brought in for questioning, he denied his involvement in the murder plan. How could he? When Kalala was brought in for official questioning, he tried for hours to deny that he was the mastermind. He told the police that he was incapable of such a thing. However, when the police played the recordings of his voice as he was confessing the plot and the reasons why he paid hired killers to murder his wife, he realized he had nowhere to go. Kalala started to cry as his guilt was presented to him, point blank. Noela, as well as the police, were still unable to find the real reason why Kalala wanted her dead. All he could ever say is that sometimes, the devil can come into someone to do something but after they do it, they start thinking, why I did that thing? The haunting memories. On December 11th of that same year, the Court of Melbourne sentenced Kalala to 9 years in prison. He pleaded guilty to the incitement of murder, which lessened the punishment given to him. Even when he was put behind bars, Noela wasn't able to get her normal life again. When she was lying alone at night, she would hear her husband's cold, emotionless voice ordering her kidnappers to kill her. She knew it would take a long time to heal, or perhaps, it would always haunt her. A new beginning for a strong woman. Despite the recorded admission from Kalala, there were some people in her community that ostracized her for her husband's conviction. Some of them who had known Kalala for so long believed that he was not capable of such a thing. Although Noela knows that the future will be difficult for her and her 8 children, she doesn't regret her decision to have him put behind bars. He had committed an unforgivable sin and her trust and love for him were gone completely. She might be devastated as a wife, but she ensures that she will take care of her 8 children for as long as she lives. After everything that happened, she knows that she needs to be stronger than ever. When asked about the people who blamed her, Noela held her head up high and said, "My situation, my past life. That is gone. I'm starting a new life now."